your child goes to hospital, it will understandably be a scary time for the whole family. Many parents feel a loss of control. Your child might be facing surgery, radiotherapy, chemotherapy, or a combination.
Her first surgery was to put a shunt in, and she came around from that very well. Her chemotherapy was always delivered through her Hickman line. I think the worst time for us was when she had her resections, because she didn't know what to expect, we didn't know what to expect. And when she came around from her first resection, I remember she woke up and both of her eyes were just turned in together. And we had the television on, and you know, the most distressing thing in the world is seeing your child's eyes just move side to side. Mm-hmm. And her not understanding, you know, what was happening. And I remember trying to lift her to cuddle her, and they'd cut through her neck muscles. And she was in agony when I tried to pick her up, and you know, we were just screaming for the nurses to come and give her something. She then had to have another surgery after that, another resection. It was the third resection, which was the hardest, because we put her on the trolley to take her down, and she was screaming, begging us not to let her have it done. You know, I don't want an operation, I don't want it to happen. And you know, that was incredibly difficult. Now she's great, actually, as long as she knows there's not going to be an ouchie. Getting a cannula into her is difficult because her veins are very small, but we manage that. And you know, she's really quite, I think she's quite enjoys hospital because she's made a fuss of, so it's helped.
As you spend time in hospital with your child, you'll be on a massive learning curve. What's radiotherapy, chemo, Hickman lines, proton therapy? Don't be afraid to ask the medical team questions if there's anything you don't understand.
I automatically assumed chemotherapy was chemotherapy, but didn't realise there's different combinations, different treatments for different types of cancers, different types of tumours. So there was a lot for myself and my husband to understand. We signed for her to have the chemotherapy, then we had the next letter to come through to say Michaela's going to need a Hickman line. What on earth's a Hickman line, you may say to yourself. Never heard of a Hickman line, never seen a Hickman line. So once again, I phoned the JR and asked, what's a Hickman line? They requested us to come up and see a dolly. It's just two wires that's just tucked underneath your breast, and that the chemotherapy can be administered. So yet another operation for Michaela. But we knew that this was going to help instead of having cannulas in the main veins of the hand. So we went ahead, had the Hickman line fitted.
We could feel anxious, very worried, intimidated by the medical professionals, which kind of almost swoop in immediately. However, that's okay, and that's normal. All our wide range of emotions, we wouldn't be human beings without them.
In a strange way, she used to quite like going up for surgery. She used to tell them, I mean, she had 26 operations in 9 months, so I think she kind of got used to it, being whipped out of her bed and into theatre, really. And used to tell them what to do, how to do it, and never really seemed, I'm sure she must have been deep down worried, but never ever showed it to anybody.
I had to spend 6 months in hospital. And once they took me out, I was like, I'm never coming back here again.
Camille had radiotherapy, or specialised radiotherapy, called proton therapy, where we flew to Florida, Jacksonville, and she had 33 doses of chemotherapy, and she had to be put out under general anaesthetic every day. The great thing about the radiotherapy was there's no ouchies. You know, she didn't. She still had her Hickman line in. The worst part about it all was her waking up post radiotherapy, because she'd be very groggy and in a bad mood. But actually, you know, there was nothing to worry her about it, which made it less of a worry for us. Because she was anaesthetised, she didn't have to sit still. You know, that was, You know, her, she never understood what it was to have the mask put on because, you know, she was only 3 as well when she had it.
Proton beam therapy is the most advanced radiation therapy available today. Because the proton beam is finely focused on the tumour, it is especially useful for treating childhood cancers. It painlessly delivers radiation through the skin from a machine outside the body. Traditional radiotherapy can damage the tissue around the tumour. However, with proton beam therapy, the protons travel to a specific depth in the body based on their energy. After the protons reach the desired depth, they deposit the specified radiation dose around the tumour site, delivering only a small dose to the surrounding healthy tissue.
It might make the tumour smaller, or, well, it, we have to have like a like turnaround scan like every month, I think, to see if it's getting bigger or smaller, or the same. If it's getting bigger when I'm not on chemo, then we're going to have to go back on it.
We are now on our third course of chemotherapy, different combinations of chemo, and we are here. We are strong. Yay!
The hospital were quite good in preparing Danielle for her radiotherapy. They showed her lots of pictures. We went down to the where she was going to have the radiotherapy. They showed her what they were going to do. They made a game out of how many layers they were going to put on to make the mask. They made a game with the mask. So she was quite prepared for radiotherapy, and that didn't really bother her either, to be honest with you. She thought it was quite funny that she had to, you know, keep still. That was the biggest chore, was keeping Danielle still without her giggling. Danielle actually thought it was really funny when she was having radiotherapy because she wanted to laugh all the way through. I obviously didn't. I was more scared than she was. I was scared when she was having the mask made, where she laid there and giggled. They had to stop it several times because she thought it was hilarious. And her biggest fear, I think, when she was having radiotherapy is that she couldn't laugh. She wanted to giggle, she wanted to laugh, but the mask was so tight she couldn't do it. So she thought that was quite hilarious.
Go and see them in hospital because that they don't feel detached. Because when you're in hospital, you do feel detached from school and they need to keep up with the gossip. I mean, they're still a person, they're still a child or a teenager, and they still want to be involved in a social life.
I don't know, you just sort of have to find something to do. I mean, I know in that situation it's not very easy, but you know, you got to find something, otherwise, because you'll just get bored and lonely, and even in hospital, that's no way to live. So, you know, go on your laptop, watch film. I watch countless films. I think that's what I did actually, just watch films. I was on my laptop a little bit, I did a little drawing. I did something as much as possible.
I would say, don't worry, you're just like me. It won't hurt you or anything, it will help you. That's what I would say.
Find a habit you can do, like just do this or that or whatever, and then you won't be scared because you'll be doing something and concentrating on that instead.
Michaela's had numerous operations whilst being diagnosed with cancer, and we struggled to get her to have the anaesthetic. So we thought together, how could we go to the treatment room to have the anaesthetic without it being tears, tantrums, and upsetting for both her and myself. So we've decided that we get the whole theatre to sing We Are The Champions before she gets put to sleep, and that works for us.
We are the champions, my friends.
Oh,
you have been affected by childhood cancer and would like advice, or simply to talk to someone who understands, please go to the JOS Searchlight website, www.jossearchlight.org.uk, where you can find full contact information. Thank you.
It always gets better. No matter what happens, it always gets better.